with qualifying finished, it's time to remind ourselves once again of our top three. Surfer Girl, Verstappen, and Lando Norris. With qualifying wrapped up now, we have our grid lineup for the big race tomorrow. Be sure to join us then for what will no doubt be a fantastic race. Welcome along then to the magnificent Suzuka International Circuit, a stone's throw away from Ise Bay in the beautiful Japanese countryside. What surprises lie in wait for us today at the Japanese Grand Prix? We're southwest of the city of Nagoya today at a wet and windy Suzuka circuit. 3.6 miles and 18 corners make up a lap here, with Sector 1 likely to prove especially difficult in these conditions. We should see overtaking into turns 1 and 16 today, and maybe a few Kobayashi-style dives into the hairpin as well. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks like for today's race. Surfer Girl lines up on pole position, edging out Max Verstappen, who'll start from P2. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Norris, Tsunoda, Daniel Ricciardo, and Sainz, Russell, Albon, Leclerc, and Pierre Gasly, Magnussen, Joe, Valtteri Bottas, and Oscar Piastri, Ocon, Hamilton, Felipe Drugovich, and Mick Schumacher, Schwartzman, Tictum, Liam Lawson, and Nicholas Latifi. And now it's time to head down to the track. Joining us today to oversee all the thrills and spills, it's Anthony Davidson. Ant, great to see you. How are you feeling about the race today, and how are the circuit conditions from what you've seen?
Well, the surface looks clean enough, but I'm a little bit worried about the track temperature. It's pretty cool out there, which could give some teams difficulties when it comes to keeping their tyres in the right operating window. The cars out there that work their tyres hard and really put a lot of energy through them, they'll be the ones that are better off.
Right then, the formation lap has started, and I must say the weather conditions aren't the best today for visibility and for grip. As each driver performs this lap, they'll be wanting to settle in and concentrate, as this race, with these conditions, will require a lot of focus. So as all the cars take their positions on the grid, the teams will be hoping their strategies pay off for them in today's race. The question I'm asking is which teams have got it right, which ones have got it horribly wrong. focus now for the rest of the race. Okay to use your overtake button. Copy that, Hards, next time we box. Dry enough yet to start thinking about slicks. Let's hold on to the inters for a little while longer.
track's going to be drying out quite soon. Be careful you don't burn out your tyres. Starting to create a gap. They're just starting to pull away from us now. They've got some kind of mechanical problem. Lando ahead. Okay, gap to the car ahead is 2.2 seconds. They're on a fresh set of inters. Their tyres are 5 laps old. We think they've got one more stop. They seem to have an issue. Your last lap time was a 1 minute 41.9. Okay, you're dropping back by around 2 tenths each lap. Drop your speed, our delta's too low and we're going to risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately. our main competitors in this race are Norris and Ricciardo. Thank you. Okay, let's get ready to go racing again. The safety car is in this lap. When the field accelerates, remember there's no overtaking until the timing line. Safety car in this lap. It's time to utilize some of this energy. Come on. DRS is now online. Verstappen's ahead of you, and gap to the car in front is 1.8 seconds. They're on fresh softs. Okay, their tyres are 7 laps old. We think they've got one more stop. Time last lap was a 1:34.3. You're losing around 1.6 seconds. 5.4 seconds. Okay, you're losing a small amount of time to the car behind, so just keep pushing. Energy. Leclerc ahead. Now gap to the car in front is 3.5 seconds. Okay, they're on fresh hards. Okay, they've done 10 laps on those tyres. And the time last lap was 1 minute 35.6. Okay, so you're gaining by 8 tenths. 8 tenths. Teammate by 5.1 seconds. some time to the car behind. We'll be right back. car in this lap. Safety car in this lap. Let's make sure those tyres are up to temperature. And remember, there's no overtaking until the timing line. Stay in position until the green flags. Got a lot of spare energy, okay to use your overtake button. Okay, clear. great finish. Well done.
Another action-packed Japanese Grand Prix comes to an end, and a magnificent drive to take the win today. Talk to me, Ants. What was it that set them apart from the competition today?
I really feel the track layout combined with the track temperatures we saw today suited their car. These cars come alive when the tyres are just at the right temperature, and the driver did a great job managing that as well. They just look so comfortable out there. It's like anything, it always looks so easy when it all just clicks.
Our drivers are making their way out for the podium celebrations, and it's going to be McLaren picking up the winner's trophy. Congratulations to the entire team for that fantastic performance. Let's have a look then at the driver's standings. Despite the best efforts of our championship leader, that lead has taken a bit of a knock today. Well, after an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
It's got to be Lewis Hamilton. I mean, he pulled off some impressive feats out on the track today, even by his standards.
Let's move on to the constructors. The current leaders continue to extend their lead at the top. Meanwhile, Alpine move up the table with another strong performance this weekend. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time out. Be sure to join us once again as we continue to bring you all the excitement of Formula One.